Hello, my name is Árni and I'm a professional audio engineer living in Iceland. Recently I made a video about the wing rack setup I was building for my band. You can see that video by clicking the link up there. After that video I've been getting some questions about the Ethicon setup I have for the pedal boards and I've been asked to explain that a bit further. I happen to have some parts lying around, so I'm going to take this panel. I'm going to show you a bit what it's all about. But basically, it's passing four wires of analog audio over Cat5 or 6 cables. I did do some very dodgy setup to get my phone up there to do an overhead shot, so we'll see if that works. I hope so. So, as you can see this here I have two types of connectors. These are all Neutrik connectors. These are the through connectors and these are the IDC punch connectors, and I'll be using these now. I will put the exact model number in the video. These are designed for Cat 5 or 6 cables. So to do this, you will need this tool. This is called an LDA or IDC punch tools or Krone connector punch tools. These can be had very cheap on Amazon or wherever, at the electronic retail store. I see this for like $3 to $5 on Amazon. This one was part of a toolkit I bought when I was buying some network stuff, so it had like a cable tester and the crimp tool, and this for like €10. Normally you would be using these with Cat 5 or 6 cables. So then you would just take the outer plastic off. And then you can see it has the four pairs of the cables. And normally I would just patch this into the connectors. Everyone in Europe seems to be using the B wiring pinout, and that is what I have always been taught to use. But I did see on Reddit that apparently A is also used somewhere. So normally these would have like a small clip that would actually go around, which would be the shield of the cable. This exact cable is not shielded, but to pass audio you want to have shielded cables if you want to be able to pass phantom power, stuff like that. It will work without it, but it's definitely better to design it to use it. So I'll just undo these and just follow the pinout. I do not need to strip the wires themselves, since the punch will actually put that together. So I'll just get this all here sorted. So you will just put them in like this, just get them to do once at a time. This tool will actually also, it has small scissors here, so it will also cut the off the end. This is maybe not the highest quality tool, so it doesn't quite cut the cables, but I like having just a small pair of flush cutters to make it a bit neater. If you had like a more expensive one, this would probably work better. But this one works for what we are doing here, so I'm gonna do the other side as well. So now this hopefully works. If I was going to use it like it is, I would use a cable tester to verify that everything works as it should. Then this would go here and the shielding clamps would go around the cable. You can see, I'll show you a picture on how it is supposed to look. But since that's not what we're doing now. So I'm gonna remove this again. Now I'm going to put audio cables into this. I had these from a previous project. It's just four ends of an eight-way multi-cable, which I cut off for a project. I'm just gonna take one of these. I'm just gonna strip all these. So once I have these all stripped, I will get them all together. And I'm going to combine the shields of all these four audio cables, like the ground wire. I'm gonna combine these because there's common ground on all of these cables. I'm just going to twist all this together. So once I have twisted these shields together, I'm going to put it into the pouch. And then now I need to figure out which one is what. Since what I'm doing here is just a temporary, just to show you how it's done, it doesn't matter. But these are actually labeled, so let's see, 5, 6, 7, and 8. From my research, there is no standard for doing audio over Cat5 cables, so between manufacturers, it's not interchangeable. Whirlwind has their own pinout, and I'm actually using the Whirlwind pinout for what I'm doing, but then there is Sound Tools, which is Dave Ratt's company, and Radial is also doing something. You can buy it from Tom, and it seems that none of these have the same wiring pinout. But the pinout I'm using is just the Whirlwind one, because that's probably just what we found first. Like, this is a project me and my friend have been working on. So I'm going to say that the cable that's number 5 will be my channel 1. And I put channel 1 on the orange pair. I'm going to show you a diagram of how I connect it. For me, this makes sense because it uses the numbers that the cables have within the Cat5, 6, whatever standard. So, cable 5 is the orange pair. Well, take 2, I messed it up. I wasn't really paying attention to what I was doing, so I wired it wrong according to the diagram I had, which is bad. So, actually, the first wire is the orange, and so this is cable 5, and that goes into the orange pair. All right, so back to number 7. So now it's all except the ground is connected. I have done this often enough by now that it starts to look familiar. On one side, the red wires will be on the inside, and on the other side, the red wires will be on the outside. This is just how my wiring setup is, and I'm just used to knowing it looks like this. I have connected like 10 or 12 of these for some projects. Now once all the whites and the reds, the plus and the minus, hot and cold, whatever you want to call them, are done, I want to solder the ground wire just to make sure it's properly attached. So I will grab my If you don't already know how to solder, I really suggest taking a day learning it. It can save you loads of money on repairing cables and doing custom solutions like this, which would cost you a lot to buy. All right, so now this is very solid and secure. That's pretty much it for this side. I would then probably put some zip ties around these cables here just to make it all a bit more secure. But this is very tight. I would of course have to measure it out. This is essentially how easy it is to do audio over CAT cables. Like, just get these through connectors and you can build your own tails however you want it. So this is just a very short introduction on how to use these and how easy it is to do your own thing. I could do all sorts of things with this. Like, this could be going into my mixer, and then I could do a CAT cable into my in-ear racks to do 2 stereo in-ears on 1 CAT cable. I always design my racks so that I only need 1 outlet and I can just loop through them the power. So this is just an example on how easy it is to do this thing, to do your own audio over CAT cables, just with these connectors. And this is just some stuff I had lying around. I hope this can inspire you to do some interesting ideas to simplify your setup. For me, when I'm playing, I want to be quick and easy to set up and spend some time actually enjoying or playing or resting. Like, I am a professional audio engineer. I do like connecting stuff, but it's so much more satisfying when things are have been well laid out and it's easy to connect and easy to get it all together. I hope this inspires some of you to start building your own stuff. Please like this video and share it to everyone who wants to listen and who you think can benefit from this setup. Please subscribe to my channel. I have some more videos similar to this one coming up. And if there are any questions at all, leave them in the comments. I will do my best to answer all questions as much as I can. I hope this was useful, and I'll see you next time.